Everyone, welcome to Basic Science Series. I'm your host Lokinder Kumar, and today we are going to discuss how to write the introduction part of your research article. I'm going to show you some of the examples from my research articles, some of the points that I consider before writing my research article. So please stay tuned till the end of the video so that you can understand all the points how to write the introduction of your research articles. One quick request before we move on to the discussion part. If you are new to the channel, please do subscribe to the channel. And if you like the video, press the like button. If you want to support my work, you can support my work on patreon.com. I'll put the link in the description box. All right, let's start the discussion. I want to mention a very simple example. The example is, if someone is asking you to introduce yourself. In this case, say someone is asking me to introduce myself. I will say, my name is Lokinder Kumar. I have done my education in this area. I'm from this part of the world. For example, I will introduce specific things about myself. I'm not going to say that I'm a human being. I have one pair of ears, I have one nose, I have one pair of eyes. Why? Because you are considering the knowledge of the audience. You know who is your audience. You know what are the things that your audience already knows, right? So it is really important that you understand your audience. That is why I always mention this point, that whenever you start writing or whenever you start doing anything, for example, even making video, you need to consider the audience. So we will start the introduction by considering this particular point, that the introduction should be written in the light of the knowledge of the audience. Right? So this is the most important point before we start writing the introduction. All right. So I hope you understand the importance of the knowledge of the audience. So the next point in this case is, I'm going to divide the introduction in four major parts. Now, before I start explaining those parts, I want to mention that whatever I'm explaining you is based on my knowledge, my experience. There are various books. There is a lot of literature on all these particular topics, that how to write the title, how to write a research article, how to write a book. You should read those topics. You know, you should read all those books, because they are really going to help you in writing your research article, whether you are even writing thesis, whether you are writing book, review article. They refine your writing skill, and they are really important. Now let's discuss what are those four major points. Point number one is, define your scientific problem. Point number two is, explain your hypothesis. Point number three is review of literature. And point number four is mention the highlight of your research article. So let's work on all those four points one by one. Let's discuss the point number one, which is define your research problem. Defining your research problem is really the important point. It's the first step towards writing the research article. So defining the problem is really important. How you can define the problem. In the particular example that I want to mention here is, for example, if you're working in an infectious disease. So what you can mention is, what are the infections associated with that particular infectious pathogen. For example, if I'm working in the area of Pseudomonas aeruginosa, or if I'm working in Staphylococcus aureus, these are the pathogens that are responsible for various infections. So if I'm working on these areas, so I will mention that this particular bacteria causes these infections in humans. And then I will, the next point that I will mention is, these are the number of infections associated with this bacteria. So you can start the introduction by giving the background of the problem. Here, I'm going to give you an example of a research article that I published. The research article was on anti-biofilm efficacy of a phytochemical. And we have proved that the antibiofilm efficacy of that phytochemical is because of its antiquorum sensing activity, right? So that's a particular scientific problem, and how I will write the introduction part of this particular research article, I will start from the infectious agent. So in this case, the infectious agent is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So I will write what are the infections associated with Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Then I will mention what are the number of infections associated with Pseudomonas aeruginosa. After that, I have to link the biofilm and quorum sensing with pseudo. I have mentioned the example of antibiofilm activity of a phytochemical via quorum sensing activity. So in that case, what I'm going to mention is the hypothesis. I'm going to mention that this particular phytochemical may be linked to the anti-quorum sensing activity by inhibiting the interaction between the receptor. So I know it's more detailed scientific explanation, but this is how you have to write your scientific research article. So you have to mention all those proteins, all those molecules that are associated with the quorum sensing signaling, and how your molecule, in this case the phytochemical, how that phytochemical is blocking or could block the interaction. So you have to mention your hypothesis very clearly, that this is the hypothesis that I want to present in this research article. So it is very important that you clearly mention or define your scientific hypothesis in this particular section. Now, the third important point is review of the literature. That is the most important point. You have to mention all the articles that were published in that particular research area. Now, the fourth point that I want to mention is the highlight of your research article. What are the key highlights of your research article? What are the result or method section that you have done? I know it depends upon person to person or their preferences that how you're going to write that, but I think it is a good point that you mention all those points, because it will again, stimulate the audience to read your research study carefully. So you can mention in that particular section that we have in the present study, we have done this, and we have found that this particular phytochemical has antibiofilm activity, and it was by blocking the quorum sensing interactions. So you can mention all those points in the end of your introduction. These are the major points that I wanted to discuss with you guys. I hope these points are going to help you while writing the introduction of your research article. Before I'll conclude the video, I want to mention that you should read all the literature that mentions how you should write a research article, what are the different parts of research article. There are a lot of books online that are available that you can read, and they are going to help you while you're writing your first research article. Thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, then please press the like button. And if you like the content of the channel, then please do subscribe to the channel. This helps me to understand how many people are watching the video and how many are there who are interested in my content, and also that motivates me to make more videos. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Take care.